Thank you. Christmases come and go. Henry writes, oppressively sad are all the holidays. Merry Christmas, say the children, but that is no more for me. Perhaps someday God will give me peace. And then Henry learns that his eldest son, Charles, who ran away to join the army, has been critically wounded in battle. Henry rushes to Washington to bring his son home, and after days of searching, he finds him barely alive. With the outbreak of war, Fanny's terrible death, and now 2 years later, his son desperately clinging to life, we should not be surprised that on Christmas Day, 1863, Henry reaches for a pen and writes, "It was as if an earthquake rent the hailstorms of a continent, and in despair I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth," I said, "for hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men." Reading his words today, we ask, when conflict rages and pain, grief, and loneliness overwhelm us, where is the music of hope and peace? For Henry, the answer to that question has everything to do with Christmas. After Fanny's death, he had written, "So strong is the sense of her presence upon me that I should hardly be surprised to look up now and see her in the room. Death is a beginning, not an end." On that Christmas morning, it was clear to Henry that war, injury, and even death can be a new beginning. The rising sun turns the icy river to silver and the windows of the Longfellow home to gold. Henry's children, bundled in their